non c'erano rivali per strada con questo tipo di veicolo, no, era un veicolo estremo. Era bello però arrivare sempre sotto tutte le vetture varie sportive di quel periodo. Vedevano una cosa così grossa e molta gente si chiedeva, ma cos'è quel coso?
È stato l'uovo di Colombo che ha permesso alla nostra azienda di emergere anche per questo genere di veicolo. È una macchina che è divertentissima da usare. Sui 180 km orari, 200, perché era facile arrivare a queste velocità, lo spostamento d'aria creava un turbinio, pum, come se fosse passato un aereo a bassa quota, e vedevi dallo specchietto retrovisore la nube di polvere alzarsi, eccezionale.
Si poteva saltare dei fossi ed entrare in campagna e darci giù. Cioè è divertirsi. Quando la si conosceva bene, trasmetteva emozioni pure. Questa è una vera Lamborghini. Punto.
You see the architecture of the LM, it's amazing, you know, because all the four seats are really put it on the outside of the car and you have this massive center tunnel. Of course, with our new car we are much more efficient in terms of package, so the seats are closer together, but we are having also a lot of space in the interior. But in terms of design, when you look at the LM, there are some really also rugged looking surfaces, but they are also perfectly to integrate some displays today, because the Urus will have really the latest technology in terms of connectivity, in terms of display. For me is really impressive, because you cannot have a more proud and robust looking front end than this one. It was really impressing me a lot. I mean, with the bull bar here and really rugged looking. I really like the front in terms of engine bonnet, because I mean, look at that. It's housing the Countach engine V12, and look at that power dome. It is almost a 10 centimeter step of a power dome. Yeah, so this is something that we really like, and in a kind of unexpected way, we are taking some inspiration of these lines and did an interpretation on the Urus. One thing in the body side for me are the wheel arches. The general feeling, of course, of the LM is really proud, the car is really tall. So we will be with the new Urus, we will be much, much lower, and it will be really outstanding in terms of proportion.
LM002 was an incredible project that was born in the 80s. But before of that, we have to remember that in the 70s, Cheetah was the origin of this idea. In that time, I don't even think that the suffix was SUV, but was a great innovative project on which there was the chance to, let's say, share the super sport approach that was part of the Lamborghini heritage together with a different spec of a car that was used for a different purpose. LM002 was produced in 300 units. And that, once again, is current with the strategy of Lamborghini. As always, we need to be sure that our product have a value for a niche, and that was also for this project a very specific requirement that started in, as we said, in the 80s. The LM002 was able to unify the two heart of Lamborghini, the supersport DNA of a car, so V12, Countach engine, so very powerful, at that time 450 horsepower, so super good. And with this new dimension, with the big wheels, with this, as we call today, SUV approach, the specification of this car was always very, very interesting by a lot of very special people, and that's why this car today has a great value and is in the hand of super special people.